partners have seen a slide that really talks about variations of performance. And Quint was talking a little bit about that as he was going through change. There's some people who are naturally high performers in the organization and they're going to jump on pretty quickly with you, but they're also going to be very scared when there's times of change because their performance is going to decline somewhat. What we have found, what we found as well as what studies have found over the last three decades, we could point to a number of studies, and we find that when in any organization, about 34% of the people in the organization are high performers, 58% solid performers, and 8% low performers. And I'm not gonna spend a lot of time talking about this slide, except the box that's there. Most of us in this room are leaders or want to be leaders, or we're leaders in some way. And so what we have learned with our partners over the past 4 years is it through this time of change in education, we cannot afford for leaders not to be in that box. So when we're talking about teachers who were having difficult conversations where they're low performing and trying to shift, or we're talking about solid performers and coaching them to move, there's a little more flexibility in being able to do that because they're new to the profession and that's our job as leaders to do that. But as leaders, we have a choice. We can either lead, and we choose to lead or not to lead. And so when we make that choice as a leader, we have to obligate ourselves to high performance. Does that make sense to everybody? And so, you know, so then somebody says, well, what does that mean? And so we put bulleted definitions in. So this is my personal piece of what I think that means, and that is we just have to have a relentless and daily focus to lead our unit to succeed. And if we don't have a commitment, you know, and I know as a leader and things that I've done, if when I have not stayed true, and I haven't at times, stayed true to that relentlessness, I've just not been very successful, nor have the people working with me been successful either. So I have great commitment to sometimes my teams not wanting me to have that much commitment to that relentless focus to help people succeed. So I wanted to take apart the flywheel just for a minute, and we'll open it up, of course, looking at a reflective activity in terms of what you learned today.